Parshiyos, Acharei and Kedoshim, two parshiyos for the price of none. Free admission here all the time. Biku Cholim of Lakewood, the best Tayamea in Lakewood, best Tayamea in the, we like to call it the five towns now in this area. And this is the second week in a row that we have two parshiyos. Next week we get a 1 week break, and then we have two parshiyos again the week after that. And we're going to discuss, we're going to speak, say a shir tonight on Parshas Kedoshim. And the pasuk at the beginning of Parshas Kedoshim, right after the Torah tells us, Kedoshim tiyu, that as a nation or as a people, you should all be holy, the Torah says. And the Torah says the next pasuk, Ish imoy ve'aviv tirou, that a person should have moira, fear for his parents, kibura ve'aim, v'yeshab soisai tishmoiru, that a person, people, Klal Yisrael, you should keep Shabbos. And the Mefarshim ask, the Mefarshim speak about, many different Mefarshim speak about, why this pasuk would come right after Kedoshim tihyu. The Torah says, be holy. And the very next pasuk, the Torah tells us that a person should have kibud avim and keep the Shabbos. What does Kedoshim tihyu have to do with those two things? So some Mefarshim explain that these two mitzvahs are really two of the best ideas about how to bring oneself to the level of Kedoshim Tiyu. Very nice, the Torah tells that people should be holy, that everybody should be holy, but how are you supposed to do it? So many of the Mefarshim say that the next pasuk, that pasuk tells us, Kibud Avim and keeping Shabbos are two of the ways, two of the express ways to bring Kedusha on to a person. The Or Chaim HaKadosh tells us that one's thinking about and honoring their parents is a segula for a very high level of Kedusha and Tahara, something which normally we wouldn't think of. But the Or Chaim HaKadosh tells us that if a person gets themselves busy with honoring their parents, with taking care of their parents, that brings you to a high level of Kedusha and Tahara, Or Chaim HaKadosh, not my own saying, but it's a very, very interesting way of looking at things. And this also applies to Shabbos, that a person that's conscious about Shabbos, that cares about Shabbos, that respects the Shabbos, it automatically brings you to the level, to a high level of Kedusha. And the Reishis Chachma says, brought down here in the Siva Shalom, he says that Shabbos is the way and the root of Kedusha. We know the Pasuk says in Parshas Bereishis, the Pasuk says, we say it in Kiddush every Friday night, Vayivorech Elokim es Yom HaShvi'i, right there you see that HaKadosh Baruch Hu injected, instilled Kedusha into the seventh day of the week, which is Shabbos. That is where Kedusha begins. The Kedusha anywhere begins from Shabbos. Shabbos is a wellspring of Kedusha, and Kedusha begins from there. The Kabrina Rav Zchus Yagan Aleinu, he says that we also say in Kiddush, Techila Lemikroi Kodesh. It is the beginning of, the way we could read that, it is the beginning of a Kedusha. Says the Kabrina that a Jew who wants to grow in Kedusha, somebody who wants to attain more Kedusha, Techila Lemikroi Kodesh, start from Shabbos Kodesh. You want to know where you should start? It's very hard to also become holy overnight. You want to start somewhere? You start with the Shabbos. So says in the Siva Shalom, beautiful pshat. He says that the pasuk is actually a continuation of the first pasuk on the parsha. First, the Torah tells us, Kedoshim to you, what HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants. HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants you to be holy. And directly in the next pasuk, right after that, the Torah tells us the best ways to become Kedoshim to you, the best ways to become holy. What are those? Shabbos and Kibud Av V'Em, something everybody should really keep in mind. And the Siva Shalom says, actually, a very deep thought, and he brings it down from Reb Moshe Midolina, Zchus HaYogin Aleinu. I'm not exactly sure where in the lineage and everything they come in. We figure out these things usually in the Shabbos Shir that we have in Shul. So whenever we get to these names, we have people in our Shir who do the research, and we find out exactly how they connect to Slonim. But he says on the Pasuk of Ishi Moiva Aviv Tiro, he says, although when a person does a mitzvah, so we look at it, that when you do a mitzvah, we see right away what's happening on a physical plane. You do a mitzvah, you shake a lulav, you put on tefillin, everything, we see that it's a physical action. We can understand the physical things that are going on with a mitzvah. But he says it goes much, much deeper than that, that by doing a mitzvah, you know what you're really doing? You're being ma'orer, the kedusha of the root of the mitzvah from Shemayim. When you keep Shabbos, when you do Kibud Av V'Em, you are stirring something in the Shemayim, and the Shefa and the Kedusha of that mitzvah in Shemayim now comes down onto you. And that's what we mean when we say, Asher Kedushanu B'mitzvah Yisav. What kind of Kedusha does a person get when you do a mitzvah? You do a mitzvah, people do mitzvahs with their hands, with their bodies. What kind of kedusha? Asher kedushanu b'mitzvah yisav. When you do a mitzvah, the kedusha that is involved with that mitzvah in Shemayim now comes down to you. You bring the kedusha onto yourself when you are mekayim a mitzvah. Because we know, it's very interesting, you know, that goyim, the umas ha'olam, goyim also, the mekayim, kibud av v'em. Also, you have people, you have goyim that are so respectful of their parents, yet, why don't they get the schar? Why don't they get kedusha? Why doesn't a goy get kedusha when they're mechabi their parents? The reason is because they're not commanded to do so. They don't have a mitzvah to do so. They're doing it out because it's the proper thing to do, and we see how the world goes when people feel it's the proper thing to do. You know, proper thing to do is also, we're worried about the environment and the climate, everything's proper, and so is respecting your parents. So that's why a goy is mechabed their parents. It makes sense. But for us, where you have a command, ishi moivah aviv tiro, now you have a mitzvah, asher kedushanu b'mitzvah yisav, you're different. You get kedusha when you perform such a mitzvah. A goyim do not get the hashpa of the kedusha from the mitzvah. We do, as Klal Yisrael, we do also. So the mitzvah of kedoshim to you in our parsha is more than just conducting oneself with kedusha. It's kedoshim to you that by doing these mitzvahs, you yourself bring down the hashpa and you become a holy person. You become a person of kedusha because you're commanded. You follow the commandment, and now the hashpois of that mitzvah comes down to you. And that's really every time the Torah talks about Kedusha, that's the way we go about it. I want to just say a little different subject from the Siva Shalom in a different piece. The Siva Shalom says, he points out that the fact that the Parsha begins with Daber El Kol Adas B'nei Yisrael, before the Torah says, Kedoshim to you, the Torah says, speak to the entire nation, El Kol Adas B'nei Yisrael. That's something which we don't find in every place in the Torah. Kedoshim to you, says in the Siva Shalom, is said to every single person on their own level. Kedoshim to you is on your level. Why? Because Ki Kedosh Ani Hashem Elokeichem. Hashem dwells and is found among everybody. Don't let anyone tell you that Kedusha only belongs to certain people, that certain people are part of the holy nation. Ki Kodosh Ani Hashem Elokeichem, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is saying that just like Hashem, as we know, there's a Mishkan in every person, just like Hashem is found within every person, so too every person needs, every person, Kedusha is attainable to every person. But says in the Siva Shalom that every person has to know that you have to look out for your Chelek Hashem that you have. You have to look out for your Kedusha, each person on their own level. You know, the Siva Shalom tells us that you are not expected to be on the level of Kedusha of a great tzaddik. Never start comparing one person, this person is so holy, more holy than that, I'm holier than you, he's holier than them. Doesn't work that way. Unless, of course, a person is taka gadol hador, then he's expected to have the level of Kedusha of a gadol hador. But otherwise, the mitzvah of Kedoshim Tiyu applies to every person on their own level. And do you know, actually, I said the mitzvah of Kedoshim Tiyu is actually not counted as one of the 613 mitzvahs for that reason, says in the Siva Shalom. Because it's different for every single person. When something is counted as a mitzvah in the Torah, one of the 613 mitzvahs, it's the same across the board. Every person has the same mitzvah, whether it's Shabbos, whether it's tefillin, whether it's lulav and esrog, whatever it is, whether it's eating matzah, everybody has the same. But Kedoshim Tiyu is not counted as one of the 613 mitzvahs for that reason, because every person has to do just what they could do. It's different for every person. It's a matana that Hashem gives us that we can attain levels of Kedusha. And if you, this is what makes us, Kedusha is what makes us into the chosen nation. But if you try to have Kedusha on someone else's level, just realize you're barking up the wrong tree. There are different levels of Kedusha, and frankly, if you don't work on your own level and you try to follow the regimen of Kedusha of somebody else, even if they're greater than you, I'm going to try to have the level of Kedusha with someone I know is greater than I am, you're still doing the wrong thing because it doesn't fit you. It's not you. HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants to see you be the best that you can be. If you're trying to do someone else's level of holiness, someone else's level of Kedusha, you might just be missing the boat. And our job really is to take this matana, this thing that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave us, this thing called Kedoshim Tiyu, and to put in our own ishtadlus, put in your own work, try to grow in our own levels of Kedusha. And the Torah tells us in this parsha, work on yourself in so many different ways. Don't be busy looking at everybody else. Just be worried about your things, your kibud av ha'em. Did you call your parents enough this week? Did you respect your parents? Did you take care of them? Your own level. Did you have respect for Shabbos? Did you treat the Shabbos Seudas the way they should be treated? Are you talking to people different on Shabbos? Do you act in Shabbos as you do during the week? But every person on their own level. Kedoshim Tiyu. It's not even one of the 613 mitzvahs because it's different. You have to just think about yourself and worry about yourself. So when we look at this week's parsha, really, Kedoshim Tiyu sounds like such a difficult thing to do. I mean, it's so ambiguous. Be holy. What does it mean, be holy? Doesn't mean you're going to eat the entire sandwich at one time. Small bites. Just think, what can I do a little bit better for Shabbos this week? We're going to come to a Friday night. Am I going to rush into Shabbos? Am I going to eat the seudas differently? Am I going to be nicer to people around the Shabbos table? Am I going to treat Shabbos? The idea, and Siva Shalom always tells us about Shabbos, is that it doesn't say a person is supposed to respect the Shabbos and delight in the Shabbos. You're not supposed to delight yourself on Shabbos. People have the wrong concept. You think that the ikar of Shabbos is how much kishka, how much gala, how much, no. That's all nice. It's all very nice. But you're supposed to make the Shabbos proud of you. And we could start this week, Kedoshim Tiyu, small steps, every single one of us on our own level.